When talking about relationships with narcissists, you often hear about these three phases. We call it idealization, devaluation, discard. And that certainly looks like it fits for romantic relationships. What about friendships? I'm going to tell you what I found, because it's similar. It's similar, right? And if you look at it as idealization, devaluation, discard, it may not quite fit exactly that. The way that I see it is it's admiration / emulation. So admiration means that this person will meet you, they will see something unique about you that they admire. They deeply admire it. In fact, it's actually the acknowledgement of the perception of your greatness or even superiority to them that makes them compelled. Now, what's gonna happen is this is gonna conjure envy and a need to attempt to be similar to you. So we talk about mirroring, and so these people will mirror you. Now, they're gonna admire you. They're going to attempt to be like you, emulate you. They may copy you. They may follow you in your career. They may get involved in things that you're doing. They may change hobbies. They may start working out. They may try to do things like you do. They will. They may copy you. Your style. They may copy your work. They may start saying things like phrases. They may try to copy and emulate the way that you think, your ideas, your persona, the way you move, the way that you communicate to other people, the way you regard and treat others. They will emulate you. Now, what will happen is during this admiration period is at some point during this game, they will seek your approval. They want you to sign off on them. They want to know that you admire them as much as they admire you. And there will be something really off about this a little bit for you. Like, they're not the real deal. That they don't actually understand things the same way you do. They're not able to be you. They can't be you. And so generally speaking, I experience that the approval-seeking behaviors and their failure to fully assimilate and become you or be really like you or to, in the interpretation of others, you see, they're also wanting others to acknowledge them. They will not be the real deal. And so there's going to be a failure. They're going to fail to be you. This is going to be like the start of what we could call a devaluation phase, but I would even call it a competition phase. That this person is now going to try to subordinate you. They're going to try to be better than you. They're going to try to get your job. They're going to try to get the promotion. They're going to try to take credit. They're going to try to be articulated as the leader. You know, so if you work with this person in some kind of group project or something, they're going to try to be like you. They're going to fail. They're going to try to hijack. They're going to try to take credit. They're going to try to peacock and posture to outshine you now. They're going to be sabotaging of you. And that's the final phase. See, the final phase with this type of scenario is what I would call the betrayal phase. You see, and it's not just that they discard you, it's that they've befriended you, they've beguiled you, they've emulated you, they've copied you, and now they're going to try to steal from you. They're going to try to acquire something from you, your team. They're going to try to take material possession from you. They're going to feel entitled to something. If you did something with them, they will feel like they put in more than you put in. They will feel entitled to your work, your intellectual property. They will feel entitled to your resources. They will feel like they're supposed to be a part of your business. Like, these types of friends and these types of colleagues suffer from deep imposter syndrome, where they, independent of the agreement of others, do not have confidence and a self-generated identity. And so they emulate other people that they admire, always falling short, always falling short, yet projecting that shortcoming onto the object of their affection or their affinity or their admiration. And so when you look at a covert narcissist and you look at a romantic relationship, you say idealization, devaluation, discard. In other forms of relationships like professional or friendships, I call it admiration / emulation with a rejection of self, like they will not measure up, followed by they're going to compete with you or sabotage or undermine. And then they're going to betray you. They're going to try to set you up in a covert way to cause you to fail because they can't be as good as you. They know that. They will never be you. And so the next best thing is if you fail. If you fail. I know there's people out here in business that came to California copying another guy that had a similar business, emulating him. And then their business continues to evolve because they copycatted this guy building the same kind of engines, then went into another type of engines, and they're doing really well. But they're a narcissist and they copy and emulate other people and then compete with them. And so the people that they admire, they end up hating those people and trying to be better than those people. And so there are certain types of covert narcissists that will always be your haters. These are people that wish they could be like you. They can be your friends. Often they will be your best friends. These people will attach and latch on to you because of your energy, because of your strength, because you're an athlete, because you're this, because you're that, and they will be secretly jealous of you. Secretly jealous of you. The things that you do to make a difference for these people often threaten them. So you can be a committed friend. You can do all of these amazing things to assist your buddy in his success. But what you fail to recognize is that the things that you do to help him violate his need to be better than you. And they will betray you. And so that's the thing, is that's why I kind of bring it up this way, is because I've had a lot of covert narcissists as friends. I've had them in work environments, and this is exactly what they do. It's just different terms because they're not idealizing you like a love partner, but they're admiring you, you know, as somebody that they may initially really see has something that they want, and now they need to prove that you're no better than they are. And so they're going to try to emulate you. And then when you don't sign off on their bullshit, or other people don't quite recognize them to be whatever the hell they're trying to be, that's when they're going after you, son.